back, guys. Today in this tutorial, I will show you guys how to create these type of cool backgrounds in Adobe Illustrator. Once you guys create this, you guys can easily change the colors of this artwork and create really cool and nice backgrounds like this in here. Okay, so let's get started. All right, guys, first thing, I'm going into the basic shapes and going to select the polygon tool in here. Okay, select the polygon shape and click on the artboard. It will open up the polygon parameters. For this design, 6-side is okay, and for the radius, I'm going to say 100. All right, 100 pixel. Okay, so we have this polygon in here. Now, same as in our previous tutorial, I'm going into object, and in here, going to select the repeat and select grid. Right, which will create the repeat grid like this in here. And again, I'm going to convert this grid to brick by column. Okay, so we will have this shape in here. And for the vertical gap, we don't need any gap, so I'm just going to select a 0. And for the horizontal gap, this one, since we add in 100 for the radius, this one the gap should be 50, so I'm just going to select minus 50 in here. Now we have filled the gap, and you can see our shapes are coming next to each other like this, which is what we wanted. Okay, now we can go in and align them to the artboard, and using the grid tool, we can fill up the entire artboard like this. And in here, we can bring it to the bottom like this. All right, guys, now what we can do is just select this object and go to the object and expand. Okay, and we don't need to expand the fill, we just need to expand the object. So deselect the fill and expand the object. All right, so now we have each of these as different objects in here. So I'm just going to select randomly in here, guys. Nothing, there's no pattern in here. I'm just going to select randomly. Make sure you are not moving anything, just randomly select these objects in here. Okay. I am satisfied with this selection. Now I'm going to change this color. For this example, I'm going to select a color from here, maybe a gray color, almost closer to black, and okay. All right, so now our second color is also ready. If you want, you guys can have more in here as well. Let's add in another set of colors. So I'm just going to select some more in here. All we are trying to do is create a randomness. In the end, all will mix together and you guys will get a nice effect, which I will show you guys in a while. And for these guys, I'm going to select a darker tone, but this time a little bit darker than this color in here. All right, okay, this look fine. Maybe let's bring it a little bit more lighter so we can see the shadows nicely. A little bit darker will be good. All right, this is perfect. All right, guys, I think we have our shape. Maybe let's add in a little bit to these in here as well. All right, guys, now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to select randomly again. Ignore the colors, just select randomly. You are trying to create this pattern as random as possible, but in the end, all mixed together will look nice. All right, now go to effects, and in here go to style and select the inner glow. Okay, which will open this inner glow option, and in here select the mode to multiple, and for the color select the black color. All right, and in here for the blurness make it 25, and for the opacity make it 25. All right, you guys can adjust based on your color. For me, I think this look fine, and you guys can see the shadow is coming inside nicely like this. All right, and make sure you guys select it from the edge. All right, and select okay. Now to avoid double selection, what you guys can do is you can open this layer and create a new layer and place them in here. and make the layer locked. Okay, all right, this layer is locked, but we are going to select the layer behind, and again I'm going to select randomly. Okay, alright, so once you have your second selection, you can create a new layer and bring them to that new layer. And for this, I'm going in again to the effects, style. This time, I'm going to select the outer glow. Okay, and again, we are going to enter the same value, but this time towards outside instead of inside like this. And again, select the multiple, and for the burners, select 25. And for the opacity, we can leave as 75 and select OK. All right. So now we have some of them inner glow, some of them outer, but all mixed together, we have this kind of sci-fi background in here. All right. Maybe we add in a couple of inner glow to these in here as well. These two, maybe just select randomly these two. Let's go in here and apply the outer glow. You can bring these to here, and now I'm just going to select this mask in here, which will be created with the original grid, and I'm going to delete it. Okay, delete it. Now what I'm going to do is select the rest, whatever the balance, and now for this, go to effects again, in the style, apply a drop shadow. Okay, and this time we can apply the drop shadow to multiple, and the offset and the blurness, I'm going to make it 25, and X offset and Y offset, you guys can adjust. I'm just going to leave 7 and 7, and okay. All right, guys. So now we have this nice shape in here. Now we can unlock these two and make all of them as one group, and we can delete these, and we can now make a clipping mask like this, and select all of them and make a clipping mask like this. All right, guys, this is how you can create this type of background designs for your artwork. And if you want to change colors, you can just double click, make sure to open the mask, select all of them, and go to recolor, and you guys can recolor from here. All right, guys, and you can also select individually if you want to, and recolor if you want. Okay, you can just select them and go into your color picker, and you can change the color to any color you want. All right, guys, so this is how you guys can easily create this type of artwork. Thank you for watching. See you guys in the next tip.